हेलो एवरीबडी, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट और नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज यूक्लिड्स ज्योमेट्री. ओके, इंट्रोडक्शन टू यूक्लिड्स ज्योमेट्री. एवरीबडी नोज यूक्लिड वॉज अ ग्रेट मैथमेटिशियन. ओके, एंड ऑल्सो वी नो दैट द ग्रीक्स डेवलप्ड ज्योमेट्री इन अ सिस्टमेटिक मैनर. यूक्लिड ऑल्सो अ ग्रीक मैथमेटिशियन. ओके, हु इज नोन एज फादर ऑफ ज्योमेट्री. Introduced the method of proving geometrical results by using deductive logical reasoning and previously proved the results. The geometry of plane figures is known as Euclidean geometry. Okay, so he derived some axioms, some postulates. Okay, so we are going to see, think about some basic concepts, basic geometrical concept. Okay, so before that, what is mean by axioms? Okay, which are derived by Euclid's. Axiom is the basic fact which are taken for granted, which are taken for granted without proof, which are taken for granted without proof are called axioms. Okay, means here proofs are not necessary. Understood? So he told us, he derived some axioms. Okay, so there are 8 axioms, so we will think about that. So first axiom is, things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Okay, means suppose we will say here A is equal to B, A is equal to B, and B is equal to C. So we can say A is equal to C. If A is equal to B, B is equal to C, then we can say A is equal to C. Okay, so this is the first axiom. Things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Okay, second axiom is, if equals are added to equal, if equals are added to equal, then the wholes are equal. Okay, suppose A is equal to B, A is equal to B, and if you will do this, A plus C, if you will add here C, then B plus C, that is equal, this is equal to this, because equal we have added in both the sides. Okay, so if equals are added to equal, the wholes are equal. Next, third one axiom is, if equals are subtracted from equals, if equals are subtracted from equals, the remainders are equal. The same thing, A is equal to B, so we can say A minus C is equal to B minus C, because C we have subtracted from LHS and RHS, so the result will be same. Okay, then fourth one is, things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. Coincides means, suppose we will take a line AB, okay, and we will take, suppose, a say one more line CD of same length, means it will coincide. Okay, so that time things which coincides with one another are equal to one another. Suppose AB and CD of same length, and we will put here, that time completely both the line segments will match, means coincides. Okay, so this means things which coincides with one another are equal to one another. Okay, then fifth one is, the whole is greater than the part. Whole is greater than the part. Okay, suppose this is a circle, so this is a part of circle. Understood? So definitely whole is always greater than the part. Next, sixth number axiom is, Things which are double of the same things are equal to one another. Okay, suppose A is equal to B, and we will take double of this, 2A, then A is equal to 2B, that is same. Okay, so here things which are double of the same things are equal to one another. Okay, so this is the sixth axiom. Okay, now next one is, things which are halves of the same thing are equal to one another. Suppose A is equal to B, then we will take, suppose, half of A, that is A by 2, then equal to B by 2. Okay, so here things which are halves, halves means half, of the same thing are equal to one another. So this was the seventh axiom. Now eighth one is, if first thing is greater than the second thing and the second is greater than the third thing, the first is greater than the third. We suppose A is greater than B and B is greater than C. A is greater than B and B is greater than C, then from this we can say A is greater than C. Okay, so these are the 8 axioms which are derived by Euclid. Understood? And we are going to use this reference to solve different type of theorems or examples. Okay, now we are going to think about postulates. Okay, what is mean by postulates? Just now we have seen axioms. Axioms is what? The basic facts which are taken for granted without proof. Okay. Now axioms, postulate means what? Axioms are the general statements. Axioms are the general statements, but postulates are the axioms related to geometry. Okay. These are also axioms, but which are related to geometry, that are known as postulates. Okay. So postulate 1. What is postulate 1? A straight line may be drawn from one point to another point. Okay, very simple postulate. See, this is one point and this is second point. So we can say this is a straight line. Okay, that line we can give as AB. Means a straight line may be drawn from one point to another point. This point to another point. Okay, so for this also we can say, given any two distinct points, this is a unique line that passes through them. Okay, suppose two points are given, then only one line we can draw from these two points, okay, or which are passing through this point. Okay, so this is the first postulate. Postulate number 2 is a terminated line can be produced independently. Okay, so terminated line means this, suppose that terminated line can be produced indefinitely, means this can be produced indefinitely. Okay, so that is the second postulate. Postulate number 3 is a circle can be drawn with any center and any radius. Okay, any center we can take, and with any radius you will get different circles. Understood? So a circle can be drawn with any center and any radius. Postulate number 4 is all right angles are equal to one another. All right angles are equal to one another means angles, all right angles are now 90 degree, so all right angles are equal to one another. Okay, postulate number 5 is if a straight line falling on two straight lines makes the interior angles on the same side of it taken together less than two right angles, then the two straight lines, if produced indefinitely, meet on that side on which the angles are less than two right angles. Means here, suppose these two lines are there, two lines are given, and this falls on this. Okay, suppose this line is AB, this line is CD. Okay, this is E, this is E, and this angle we will say this is EM. Suppose we will say this is angle 1 and this is angle 2. Okay, so according to this postulate, we can say angle 1 plus angle 2 is smaller than 180 degree. Is smaller than 180 degree. Understood? So this is supplementary when lines are parallel and cut by transversal, that we have seen. Understood? So this is the postulate number 5. Okay, see here, our next point is statements. So what is mean by statements? A sentence which is either true or false but not both is called a statement. Okay, means we can say sun rises in the east, it is true sentence. Okay, 2 plus 2 is equal to 5, that is false statement. Means such type of sentences, a sentence which is either true or false but not both is called a statement. Next is theorem. Theorem is what? Statement that requires a proof is called a theorem. Okay, we have seen many theorems. So on that basis also you can understand, statement that requires a proof is called a theorem. Okay, the process of establishing the truth of a statement through logical reasoning based on axiom is known as proving the theorem. Okay, how to prove, how we are proving, how we give reasons, okay, for the proof, that we have seen. Understood? So that is theorem. Then after this, corollary. Okay, so what is mean by corollary? Corollary means result deduced from a theorem. Okay, result deduced from a theorem is called a corollary. Understood? So theorem is what? Euclid gave some postulates and axioms. Okay, we have seen Euclid gave some postulates and axioms. With the help of these postulates and axioms, he proved some results. On using these results, he proved some more results by applying deductive logic. The statements that were proved are called proposition or theorem. Understood? So the statement which are proved that are called theorems. Euclid proved 465 theorems in a logical manner using his axiom and postulates. How many theorems? 465 theorems he proved with the logical manner using his axiom and postulates. Okay, now some points we are going to discuss. Already you all are knowing that point, line and plane. Point, line and plane. Understood? Point means what? What is mean by point? It has neither length or breadth. Point means just a dot, neither length or breadth nor thickness. It is denoted by a point, a fine dot on a paper. It is represented by the capital letter. Any capital letter we can use for point. Okay, then line. What is mean by line? Line, if we fold a piece of paper, the crease in the paper represents a line. Means this is a line. Okay, which we can extend from both the sides. We have seen. Okay, a line can be extended to any length on both the sides. It has no end points. A line has no breadth also. A line can represented by a smaller letter. Line can represented by a smaller letter. Generally we use L. There can be unlimited number of lines that can be drawn through a given point A. Suppose this point is given. Unlimited lines can be drawn from this. Okay, there can be exactly one line that passes through the two given points. Okay, suppose two points are given. We have seen two points are given, then only one line we can pass, we can draw from this. Okay, then line segment. What is mean by line segment? A portion of line is called a line segment. Suppose this is a line L. So if I am taking this much portion from this, so AB is a line segment. Okay, so a portion of line is called line segment of the line or line segment. Line segment is the subset of the line. Line segment is the subset of the line because this is a part of the line. Understood? Okay, so it can be written how we can write a line AB or B also. Okay, a line segment has two end points. Here two end points are there. It has a particular length, means we can measure it. Understood? A line cannot be drawn fully on the paper because it extends. Line cannot draw because it can be extended. Understood? Next is congruent segments. Congruent segment is suppose AB, this AB and CD having same length. Understood? So we can write AB is congruent. This is the side of congruent CD. Understood? So there are some properties for this. Here see, AB is congruent to AB. AB is congruent to CD. Okay, CD is congruent to AB. Okay, AB is congruent to CD. CD is congruent to, suppose one more line we have taken EF. One more line we will take EF. If AB is congruent to CD, CD is congruent to EF, then we can say AB is congruent to EF. Okay, so this was about congruent segment. Opposite rays. Opposite rays means see, this suppose this is a ray and this is a ray. Understood? So this we can suppose B, we will say here A and here this is C. So ray AB. Ray AB. Understood? And ray AC. AC and AB. Okay, because this is here, this point we can extend, that point we can extend. So arrow will come here, AB, B side it can be extended. Okay, now we are going to think about incidence axioms. Okay, we are thinking about incidence axiom. So see, what is first incidence axiom? If there is a point P on line L, okay, we are considering here there is a point P on line L. Okay, then we can say, what we can say about this? P lies on L. Okay, we can say P lies on L. Or we can say P is incident on L. P is incident on L. Or we can say L contains, line L contains point P. Okay. Or we can say L is passing through the point P. Okay. So like that, any from this four we can use any statement for this. Okay. So here first incidence axiom is a line contains infinitely many points. A line contains, suppose this is a line, infinitely many points. That point we cannot count. Okay. So a line contains infinitely many points. So this is the first incidence axiom. Okay. Second incidence axiom is an unlimited number of lines that can be drawn through a point. Unlimited. Suppose this is a point. Unlimited number of lines we can draw. We cannot measure. So this is the second incidence axiom. Third one. Third incidence axiom is given two point distinct points A and B in a plane. There only one line containing them. Understood? So one line we can draw. If two points are given, then only one line we can draw from them. Fourth incidence axiom C. Two lines may or may not have a common point. Two lines may or may not have a common. Suppose these two lines are there. It has a common point. But two lines are suppose parallel. There is no any common point. Understood? So this is the these are the incident axioms. Understood? So now after this we are going to see collinear points. Collinear point means three or more points are said to be collinear. When we can say collinear, if they lie on the same line. Okay, suppose A, B and C are on the same line, then we can say these are the collinear points. Understood? Concurrent point. Concurrent point means suppose this is a point and the line, all lines are passing through this point. Suppose this point is P. So we can say P is the concurrent point. So three or more than three lines are said to be concurrent if there is a point which lies on all of them. Understood? So all these lines are given. Plane. Plane means what? It is a flat surface. This is also a plane. It is a flat surface which extend indefinitely in all directions. Understood? So that is plane. So these are some basic concepts we have seen. Okay. So properties of planes. What are the properties of planes? Through three non-collinear points, one and only one plane passes. Okay. Three non-collinear points. Only one and one. Suppose these three points are there. So only one. This is a plane. Okay. So such type, second property is one and only one plane can be drawn containing two intersecting lines. And third property is two planes either intersect exactly in a line or are parallel. Okay. So these are the some properties of plane. Okay. Now we are going to see exercise 5.1. NCERT exercise 5.1 we are going to discuss. Okay. So from that first is only one line can pass through a single point. Okay. Only one line can pass through a single point. If single point is given, then only one line we can draw, like that statement is given. So definitely this statement is false. This statement is false because if you can take any one point and you can see an infinitely many lines we can draw from this, and we have seen this just now. Okay. So this statement is false. Second one is there are an infinitely number of lines which pass through two distinct points. Okay, suppose two distinct points are given and infinitely many lines we can draw, like the statement is given, and this statement is false because only one line segment which we can draw from the any two point is given, then only one line we can draw. Third one, what is given? See, a terminated line can be produced indefinitely on both the sides. Terminated line is what? See, next one, a terminated line can be produced indefinitely on both the sides. Indefinitely on the both the sides. Both the sides means what? Terminated line. This is terminated line. Terminated line. This is the line. So it can be extended from both the sides. Understood? So this statement is true. Now, fourth one, if two circles are equal, then their radii are equal. So this is true statement, because if circle, this is circle, radius is 1 centimeter and here this is 1 centimeter. If you will superimpose, then they will completely match. Okay. On superimposing the region bounded by one circle on the other circle, it is found that two circles coincide. okay. So then their centers and boundaries coincide, therefore the radii will be equal. Okay, so this is also true statement. Okay, now frequency, here figure is given, 5.9, AB is equal to PQ, PQ is equal to XY, so AB is equal to XY. Okay, so this is also true, we have seen, because things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Okay, so we have seen this in axiom. Okay, so this was the first question. Now question number 2C, which give a definition for each of the following terms. Are there other terms that need to be defined first? What are they and how might you define them? Okay, so first one is parallel lines. First one is parallel lines. Understood? So parallel lines, what? Two lines are said to be parallel when they are not intersecting and they are coplanar. Okay, two lines are parallel when they are not intersecting and they are coplanar. Understood? Means they will never intersect each other. So that time we can say lines are parallel. Perpendicular lines means what? Second one is given, perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines means two lines AB and CD. Suppose this is AB and this is CD. Okay, AB and CD are perpendicular when we can say lying on the same plane are said to be perpendicular if they form a right angle. Here right angle, then we can say that lines are perpendicular. Then line segment. Line segment means what? A line segment is a part of a line. We have seen line segment. This is line segment and suppose this is a line. This is AB. Okay, line L. So AB is the part of line L. Okay, so we can say a line segment is a part of line with two ends. Okay, we can measure the length of line segment. When two distinct points A and B on line are given, then the part of this line with end points A and B is called line segment AB. Okay, so this is the line segment. The next one is radius. Okay, radius, what is meant by radius? The distance from the center, of a circle to the circumference. Okay, circle is called the radius of the circle. Okay, so this point and on the boundary, so whatever distance is there, that is known as radius. Okay, square. Next one is square. Square means what? A quadrilateral in which all four angles are right angle and four sides are equal is called a square. Okay, is called a square. Now next question, see, consider two postulates given below. First one, given any two distinct points A and B, there exists a third point C which is between A and B, and second one, there exist at least three points that are not on the same line. Do this postulate contain any undefined terms? Are this postulate consistent? Do they follow from Euclid's postulate? Explain. Okay, they are asking. So after reading this, you will get C. There are several undefined terms which the student should not list to explain. They are consistent because they deal with two different situations. Here there are two different situations are there. Okay, so first one, what is given? C. Say that the given two points A and B, there is a point C. A and B, two points are given. There is a point C lying on the line. Lying on the line. Okay. In between them. Okay. This is in between. Suppose AB and this is C point. So this is lying between AB. Second, what we can say? A and B, we can take C not lying on that. Suppose this is AB and C is not lying on that. Okay. So they follow from third incident. Okay, that just now we have seen third incidents. So through two distinct points there is a unique line that pass through them. Understood? So this is the explanation for this example. So definitely this is not followed from the Euclid's postulate. Okay, next question, see, if a point C lies between two points A and B such that AC is equal to BC, then prove that AC is equal to half of AB explained by drawing on one figure. Okay, so suppose according to the question, we will take AB here and C is here. Okay, and AC is equal to BC. AC and BC means C is the midpoint of AB. Okay, so we have a point C lying between two points A and B, such that AC is equal to BC. Okay, so what we can see here, AC is equal to BC. Suppose we will add AC plus AC, and here also we will add BC plus AC. Means we have added same. Equals are added in equals, result is equal. Okay, so AC plus AC is 2AC is equal to BC plus AC, means what? AB. Okay, so here from this we can give proof AC is equal to half of AB. AC is equal to half of AB. Okay, now next question, see equation 4. Point C is called a midpoint of line segment. Point C is called midpoint of line segment AB. Prove that every line segment has one and only one midpoint. Okay, this we need to prove. So what we can say, if possible, let one more line I am taking here. This is the same line A, B, and C is the midpoint. Then what we need to do, if possible, let D be another midpoint of AB. Suppose this D is also midpoint of AB. Okay, that we need to consider. So what we can say, AD is equal to DB. If this is D is midpoint, then we can say AD and DB are equal. Okay, but what is given? It is given that C is the midpoint. C is the midpoint of AB. Okay, so we can say AC is equal to CB. AC is equal to CB. Understood? So this is, suppose I will say 1 and this is I am saying second one. So subtract 1 from second. 1 from second. AD minus AC is equal to DB minus CB. Okay. AC minus AD. AC minus AD is equal to CB minus DB. Okay, so AC minus AD means what is remaining? DC. Okay, is equal to CB minus DB, which is not possible. Okay, so we can do DB minus CB. If you will do DB minus CB, you will get minus DC. Okay, so DC will come this side, DC plus DC, 2DC is equal to 0. Okay, so C and D are coincide. Means C and D are the same points. Okay, so this is the explanation for second last question. Now one more question is there. Question number 6. What is question number 6? In figure, AC is equal to BD. Okay, prove that AB is equal to CD. Figure is given. A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So what is given? AC is equal to BD. But AC is equal to what? AB plus BC. Okay. So BD is equal to what? BD is equal to BC plus CD. BC plus CD. Understood? So point C lies between B and D. Okay. So what we can say? AC and BD. So AB plus BC. What we can say? AB plus BC is equal to BC plus CD. After this, what we can say? AB plus BC minus BC. Okay, equals are subtracting from equals, then the result is equal. Okay, so BC plus CD minus BC. Okay, so BC, this will be cancelled. So what is remaining here? AB. This BC will be cancelled. AB is equal to CD. AB and CD are equal. Okay, so this way we have solved exercise first one. Second exercise, you have to solve, only two questions are there. For that, you need to read all the theorems. Some theorems are given, theoretical part is given, okay, which I have not taken, but already you all are knowing the properties. So go through the NCERT textbook, read whole lesson, try to understand axiom, postulates, whatever it is given, and try to understand the theorems which are given and which are very simple. Okay, and then solve exercise number 2, NCERT exercise number 2. Okay, thank you very much. So this lesson is completed here. Thank you.